Hello friends, welcome to Abstract Factory Design Pattern in C++ video tutorial. So first of all, what are the contents? So what is Abstract Factory Design Pattern and the fundamental diagram? I will be explaining with that help of diagram. And why and when to use Abstract Factory Design Pattern and the UML diagram of the class hierarchy and the program which is written in C++. What is Abstract Factory Design Pattern? So Abstract Factory Design Patterns defines an abstract class for creating families of related objects. Please note this, guys, families of related objects, but without specifying their concrete subclasses. So please note this point, we are going to create families of related objects. So let's try to understand the whole concept with this diagram. So as you can see, this is a car factory, this is an abstract factory, and these two are concrete factory. So I have taken a very simple example to explain. These two factories will be responsible for creating the related object, as you can see here. So this simple car factory will create tire 1, body 1, which will be related to particular factory, okay? And this is again the tire and the body, but this is second tire and second body, means type 2 and body type is also 2. So this is, as you can see, this is the whole different series of object, and this is whole different series of object, but the objects are same, okay? So let's take an example. Say you are having a car factory, let's say Mercedes-Benz car. So you won't be going and constructing different factories, like Mercedes-Benz is having so many classes, okay, like class A, class B, C. So you won't be going and constructing all different factories for creating the same Mercedes-Benz. What you will do, you will make one physical factory, and then you will go and apply some changes or configure something so that it will start building some different class car, like class A car, and after that you configured it for the class B, so like that. So at the same time you can have different types of cars, okay? So this is how it is. You will create all objects which are totally different than the another factory's object, but those objects will be same. As you can see, this is the tire and this is also a tire, okay? But this tire belongs to some another class of car, and this tire belongs to some another class of car. So initially you will be initiating some factory which will do the whole work for you, okay? As you can see the diagram here, that explains very well. And yes, these whole series of objects is nothing but the car object. This is whole one car object which will have tire and body in that. So this is also one another car object. So let's move to next slide. Yes guys, why and when to use Abstract Factory Design Pattern? So the first point is, let's say you need some system to be independent of how the objects are created, composed and represented. That means you don't want to reveal anything to the client, okay? Client won't be having any power to change or change inside the object, like how the object is being created and what are the composition of the objects and how the object is represented, okay? And the second point is, you will be just showing the interfaces, not the implementation part of that whole software or the whole class and all that. So in that case also you will use this Abstract Factory Design Pattern. And the third and the main important point which you really use for this Abstract Factory Design Pattern is, let's say you want a system that configured with one of the multiple families of objects, okay? Remember guys, you will be developing series of object which will be related to each other, and sometime you will be creating another series of object which will be related to each other, okay? So at a time you will be creating one series of objects only. So let's go to another slide. So here you can see that this is our UML diagram. This is the same diagram what I have implemented in C++ code. So this is the abstract car factory which is inherited into simple car factory and the luxury car factory. I have given this build whole car. This is the public object, public interface which this client will be calling. So and will return this car object. So this car object is nothing but the final object what we are getting. Okay, so this car object is composing this tire and body object. So this tire and the body object looks like this, and this is again an interface. So simple tire will be there and the luxury tire will be there, simple body and the luxury body will be there. So once we will go through the code, then we'll understand it more. So let's look at the code now. So this is the code. You can see that there are two factories here. One is simple car factory and another is luxury car factory. And these are the switches, like simple car and luxury car, which I'll be turning on and off while I'm compiling. So this will work as a configuration, like I'll be configuring the whole factory or the whole thing to build a simple car, and at next time I'll be switching it to the luxury car. So it will build the luxury car object. And once this factory is set, I'll just say build the whole car, it will return the car. And this function I'm using to just to show you that, okay, what type of car is it. So this was our client. Now let's look at the factory here. This is our abstract factory class. This is a car factory, and we have inherited this factory into this concrete classes, like simple car factory and the luxury car factory. So this is how it looks like. I'll take you to the whole code. Actually, this code is uploaded on GitHub, and I have given the link to the description field of this video, so you can go ahead and check that. So let's start from the beginning. I will take you through the whole code. So as you can see here, we have turned on this luxury car right now. So the luxury car factory will be assigned to this factory object, and it will build the related car. So let's see this function. So where is the luxury car function? Yeah, this one is the function. Okay, so as you can see, it is creating the luxury car. I mean, I'm just giving the name of the car as luxury car, and we are setting the tire and the body. So the build tire and build body is nothing but just the function which is returning the appropriate tire and the body. Like if it is the luxury car factory, then it will be returning the luxury tire, and if it is the simple car factory, then it will return the simple tire. It's that simple, guys. So this is how it looks like. Okay, so let's go and check the object. So this is our car object. It is having three parameters, like the name of the car, I mean whether it is a luxury or a simple, and the tire type and the body type. So here we are setting it. We are setting it in this through the factories. We are sending that, and it is getting set here. And this one extra print function is there, which I am using to show the details only. Okay, not a big thing. This is the tire abstract class, which I am inheriting this into simple tire and the luxury tire. Simple tire will have its name, like simple tire, and what is this 75? 75 is nothing but the pressure, what pressure it can handle. So as it is simple tire, it can handle 75% of the pressure or something like that. I've just given for the namesake, like for just for the example to understand that. And the luxury will be able to handle that 100% pressure or something, and the same for the body also. So when I'm going to construct this body, so there is a body abstract class. This will act as a interface. So simple body is there and the luxury body is there. So simple body will be having like 75. What is this 75 here? Yeah, strength. So the body will have strength. So as this is the simple body, it will have less strength, and in case of luxury body, it will have more strength. So this is how it is, guys. I hope you understand, and if you don't understand, please ask in the comment section. I'll be answering you, no worries. So yeah, Let's go ahead and run this code. Yeah, it compiled successfully. So we are building this luxury car. If you remember, that option was luxury car. Now if I'll comment this, and if I'm going to build a simple car, then you would be seeing simple car. Yeah, simple car. So recompilation is nothing but I'm just reconfiguring my whole factory. Okay, so as I told you in the slide, that if I'm having some factory like Mercedes-Benz factory, then I won't be creating different classes factory separately. I mean physically separate factories. I'll reconfigure the factory which is already there. I mean the one factory, and I will create several classes of the cars. So that's the whole idea, guys. I hope you understand, and if you don't understand, please ask me in the comment section. I will surely give you the answers. And if you found any problem in this code, you can tell me. So thank you for watching this video, and if you like the video, please like it and subscribe, so that you in future if I upload any videos on a design pattern, then you will get update for that. Or if I update any videos which is interesting, like in C++, then oh my god, that was dog sound. Yeah, crazy. I won't edit this, I'll keep it. So yeah, thanks for watching this video. Bye bye.